Hey guys, Carissa Rose here. So I use Sharpies with a lot of my watercolor pieces, so today I am testing out our Sharpies waterproof. For this experiment, I used the original fine tip Sharpie marker, and I also tested out the fine tip Sharpie pen, and I am doing this test on watercolor paper. It is Canson brand 140-pound weight watercolor paper. So I added some scribbles with the marker and pen, and actually let it sit and dry for about half an hour before going back over with water. With the Sharpie all dry, I went straight over it with some water. Went pretty rough to try to see if I could get the Sharpie to bleed. Going pretty rough, there was a slight amount of bleed. It wasn't too bad on the Sharpie marker, but you can see where that kind of shadows were. On that second little patch I did, I just very lightly went over it and there was no bleed at all. And now this darker patch, I'm going over very roughly to see how much it bleeds. When you go really, really roughly, the marker definitely bleeds a bit more. The less water you use and the lighter you are with your brushing, you can easily go over the Sharpies without getting a lot of bleed if you are careful. And I did find when going over this patch of Sharpie, which was a patch of Sharpie that I had gone over many times, that it bled much more than the Sharpie above it, which wasn't colored in as much. So I think the lighter you draw with the Sharpie initially, the better. If you're going to be painting over it, you can always go back later and add Sharpie after you do the watercolors to get your outlines as dark as possible. Now for the Sharpie pen, this first little patch I painted in very lightly and there was no bleed. The second patch I'm going over now, I went over much more roughly and there was quite a bit more bleed. It picked up some of the Sharpie pen ink. As you can see, it's spreading all over the paper. And for this last patch, you can also see that the same sort of effect happens. The more water and more pressure you use, the more the Sharpie pen will pick up and spread around and muddy up your water. If you're using colors, it would muddy up your color a little bit. But with plain clear water, you can really see how much it truly does bleed and pull up the ink. Again, though, that's when using lots of pressure. And when going over the piece of Sharpie pen that I had gone over and over with the pen, you can really see how much it picks up the Sharpie pen. And it picks up the Sharpie pen much more than the actual Sharpie marker. So that's how it looks all dried up. I decided to add some more Sharpie pen and marker to go over with actual watercolor. And I'm going to be going over it with Pring professional brand watercolors. I personally use Sharpie pens and markers for almost all of my outlines before I do the watercolors. It definitely takes some practice and getting used to the feel of it, but you can see how when you go lightly, it really doesn't pull too much color and bleed up. So if you make a rough outline first and then go over with watercolors, you can easily go back over your outline after the watercolors have dried completely. And that will end up with a much better result, especially since you'll see that the watercolors over the Sharpie pen and marker do tend to fade the Sharpie also because of the opacity of the pigments going over it. And here's what it looks like going rough with the colors. You can see that when you go rough, you're gonna get some of that black from the Sharpie pulled up just like when it was straight water. So here is what it looks like all dried up. As I said before, you can go back over with your Sharpie pens and markers, which I'm about to demonstrate, kinda. I didn't really do like a perfect overlap of the lines, but you can really get the idea and see how much darker it is after going back over it again. And that's typically what I do with pretty much every piece. I'll always go back over the Sharpie pens and markers. It really makes a lot of a difference. So you can see when you go rough, those spots really bled. But the nice light areas show no bleed, even though I did go over them with water. So a little smiley face for using little pressure. And if you take a look down at that yellow covered Sharpie mark and see how light it is, This is where I would go back over with Sharpie after it's completely dry. Make sure it's dry because your Sharpie won't want to draw on a wet surface. But it makes all the difference for a final piece to make it really refined and make all those little details pop when you put work into it. It's worth it for the outcome. Okay, well, I hope this video has been informative. If you're curious about using Sharpies with watercolors, I hope I gave you a couple of useful tips. Thanks so much for checking out my video, and be sure to check out more drawing and painting videos on my YouTube channel. All right, guys, have a great week. Toodles.